The fact that we VIPs, rich people, powerful, influential people, continue to live a comfortable, too luxurious life in Tihar jail is not known, new. But what is the problem is the fact that it continues even in 2021. Is the fact that in Tihar jail, people are able to access not just laptops or you know, your regular cigarette or even a bottle of alcohol or a mobile phone, but are able to run operations, live in luxury, get gadgets in, live in a place, in a room with curtains on allow, such that the luxury inside is not even visible to rest of the people, but everybody knows what's going on. All of these transgressions are still going on. The fact that people can run their entire businesses sitting inside, run their entire extortion racket sitting inside, plot murders, plot all kinds of criminal conspiracies sitting inside, give instructions to their men outside, still continues in 2021. And that to me is a big issue. Mirror Now has access CCTV footage of the Tihar jail yet again that shows con man Sukesh Chandrasekhar. Now, Sukesh Chandrasekhar is an accused in a 200 crore rupee extortion case. And this con man, who is now behind bars, is actually only behind bars on paper. He's pretty much leading a comfortable free man's lifestyle inside the jail. Continues to indulge in all of the criminal activities, operating through all the gadgets that he has access to. The CCTV footage shows that Sukesh was using a barrack, an entire barrack, meant to be shared with dozens of others, all by himself. So he had his own bungalow, in a sense, inside Tihar jail. The area around his bed can also be seen covered with bed sheets, curtains, all for his privacy, such that nobody disturbs this VVIP criminal. Details on the Delhi police charge sheet reveal the accused conman had paid 60 lakh to 75 lakh per fortnight. 60 to 75 lakh per fortnight for using a mobile phone in jail. Also used the phone to make extortion calls in jail. He's paid 25 to 30 crore allegedly to the staff in 1 year for all the luxuries that he wants. So if you have the money and you have lots and lots of money, and whether you are inside jail or outside jail, doesn't matter in this country. How do we fix this problem such that what we were discussing 15 years earlier isn't still happening in our country? Let me say good evening to the panelists who are joining me right now. Shashi Kant, former DG Prisons in Punjab, joins me this evening. Also, we have Bhaftar Singh, our in-house expert, joining us on this conversation. Bhaftar, I want to start off with you. This well-set network which exists in Tihar jail, why is it that in all of these years, nobody has been able to break through this corrupt network?
Well, Tanvi, this time around, it has been brought to the notice of authorities, and more importantly, this has been reported by the media. But this is not one of the cases as far as Sukesh Chandrasekhar incident is concerned. Let me just bring you what has happened this year alone. Now, it started with the Enforcement Directorate submitting a report in sealed cover to the Supreme Court, in which they said that Unitech promoters Sanjay Chandra and Ajay Chandra were virtually running an underground office from Tihar jail premises, which led Supreme Court shifting Ajay and Sanjay Chandra to Mumbai jail immediately and asking for an inquiry by the Delhi Police Commissioner Rakesh Asthana. And following which, the crime branch registered a case against 37 Tihar jail officials under sections of Prevention of Corruption Act and Criminal Conspiracy, and also other sections of Indian Penal Code. Apart from that, CBI has also filed a case against a deputy superintendent and 12 other officials of Tihar jail in a case in which an under trial was brutally murdered by Tihar jail officials. In this particular case, 12 CCTV cameras were not functioning and they were covered, much like Sukesh Chandrasekhar case. And also, there has been a case reported in which an under trial who was to be released from Tihar jail just a day prior, he was also found murdered. So there have been several cases this year alone in which Tihar jail officials have been found complicit of some crime or other. More importantly, in case of Jitendra Gogi, who was gunned down in Rohini court by another rival gang, the entire planning, according to the crime branch of the Delhi police, took place inside Tihar jail premises. Now, this clearly shows that as far as Tihar jail is concerned, India's biggest prison or even Asia's biggest prison, it is virtually a free-for-all, or virtually it's a fiefdom for prisoners who are powerful, who are rich, and who have connections.
Yeah, and stories that we used to hear, you know, 15 years ago, and you just counted off, you know, off your fingertips, stories that have happened just in the last few months. And nothing seems to have changed. And that's what really, you know, concerns me and surprises me, that as long as you have money, Tihar jail can be a luxury five-star hotel stay for you. And nothing changes. In fact, the more dangerous part is, Mr. Shashikant, the system may want you to believe that we have successfully put a criminal behind bars. But a criminal is not just living in luxury. He's continuing with his criminal activities, plotting more, you know, shootouts, murders, whatnot, extortion bids, sitting inside the jail. Now, how do we break through this and why are we not able to do it?
I don't know about Bihar or all these places, but I'll talk generally about it. And my opening comment is that you guys don't know even a bit of what all is going on and what all goes on within the precincts of various prisons. First, you talked about the will to, government's will or authorities' will to do something about it. Unfortunately, there's no national prison policy even. In 1983, if I'm not wrong, Justice Mulla Committee was put in place. Then 87, V.R. Krishna Iyer Committee was put in place. Then I think, if I'm not wrong, 18, I think Mr. Justice Roy's Committee was put in place. They submitted the report in 2020, but nothing has been implemented till now. This is the part of you said that you were surprised, and I don't know whether to call it complicity or what to call it, but till now there is no national policy as far as the prisons are concerned. And prisons, again, let me tell you, are overcrowded. They don't have funds. They don't have staffing. I'm talking about luxuries. You mentioned, I know one particular prison house where even air conditioners were put in for the sake of the concerned prisoner. There were air conditioners. So how do you do it? Unfortunately, whatever is happening in the prison house is exactly what is happening in the open society, as far as this activities or acts of the persons who can afford to purchase the criminal system, this entire system, like whether it's government system or it's legal jurisprudence or whatever it is. Whatever happens in the open society, situation within the jails is worse than that. You can get whatever you want within the prisons, but at a price. And when I say whatever you want, let your imagination go totally wild on it.
No, you're absolutely right there, Mr. Khan. Although I just have to say that, you know, we can only say as much for which we have the evidence to present to our viewers. And so we are using the visuals that have actually come out, like Bhavtosh was pointing out. These ones have come out in the media. Bhavtosh, specifically, and I come back to the, you know, to the aspect of Tihar. The new police commissioner has also spoken about this issue in the last couple of months. Like you said, too many instances have come out. There has been assurances of looking into it. But is that even possible? Because, you know, often experts tell us that the Tihar jail setup is too complicated. Which authority runs which part? Where are the people, the staff members really coming from? Where are they deputed from? Who are they answerable to? Does that all also complicate the issue?
Yes, Tanvi. In fact, Tihar jail administration is in the hand of Delhi government. Tihar jail, the top boss of Tihar jail is someone who is a DG rank official, a pretty senior IPS officer, but the administration is in the hand of Delhi government. But in this particular case, this year alone, the entire administration of Tihar jail has been under the scanner of not only the Delhi police, but also under the scanner of the Supreme Court. Now, the division bench of Justice Chandrashud even said, even was shocked by the report that was prepared by the Enforcement Directorate and asked the Home Secretary what steps are being taken so that at least such incidents, the manner in which Ajay Chandra and Sanjay Chandra were accused of running an underground office from inside Tihar Jail of Tihar Jail is not repeated. Now, the commissioner of the Delhi Police was very clear in saying that 37 Tihar Jail officials, not one, two, but 37 Tihar Jail officials were helping the promoters of Unitech to run this, run their office. More importantly, the manner in which Ankit Gujar and under trial was brutally beaten and killed inside Tihar Jail officials is something that has shocked even CBI officials. Now, I will just quote from the status report that was prepared by the Delhi Police and then subsequently by the CBI. They have said that he was so badly beaten at around 1 a.m. in the morning that that he could not regain his consciousness. Despite that, none of the doctors from Tihar Jail came to help him or provide some kind of medication. He was led to die inside his ward, and only at 6 a.m. doctors were in fact informed, and then he was shifted to the hospital. Now, his postmortem report also said that he was beaten up very badly. There were injury marks on his body, and there were injury marks through blunt objects. This is a clear case of murder as far as Ankit Gujar is concerned. And the crime branch also said that the entire planning of Jitendra Gogi, who was shockingly killed inside a judge's chamber or inside the courtroom, was done from inside Tihar Jail premises in a ward which does not even have mobile signals, which had jammers. And the planning happened from inside jail, and it took nearly 1 or 2 months of planning.
So this planning, and I want to highlight this case specifically because makes the case for a bigger danger, because Bhavtosh, it's not just about people, you know, sitting in air conditioned jail rooms anymore, or having access to alcohol or cigarettes or laptops or phones. They're actually managing to execute crime while behind bars.
Yes, Tanvi, in fact, as many in Delhi police have said, that you can carry out gang rivalry from inside Tihar Jail, you can make extortion calls from inside Tihar Jail, and you can virtually run your fiefdom from inside Tihar Jail. And there have been numerous cases in which extortion calls have been made from Tihar Jail, and several such cases have been unearthed not only by the Delhi police, but even by the district police.
Okay.
So these have been brought to the notice of Tihar Jail administration. Steps have been taken, but the sheer volume of under trials who are lodged there, there have been attempts by the administration also, one must say. There are now 3 or 4 jails in Tihar, as well as across Delhi. But the manner in which these jails are run by the administration is something that needs to be answered by the administration, and immediate steps should be taken.
Okay, so we come back to the big point, Mr. Shashikant, what you were saying about having a comprehensive national policy. To your mind, what would be the key things that entails that we don't currently have?
Look, the very first thing, which various committees have also recommended, as on date, unfortunately, the prison remains a state subject. And you know the how state governments are generally run. They run as for whatever the chief politician demands others, they run like that. There is the most important thing. There should be the concurrently so that there is some interference, or the government of India can also intervene in the cases, in such this kind of cases, as long as it remains exclusively a state-level subject. And unfortunately, I don't think the things are going to improve. And all the committees have consistently said this thing, that it has to be on the concurrent list. And the things which need to be done is to ensure that there has to be proper staffing. There has to be proper rotation of these warders, or whatever they are called, officials posted in the prison houses. Unfortunately, most of these guys, they remain at the place where they had joined, and they remain the same place till their retirement. So what does it mean? That means naturally, obviously, they're going to have their own links and their own deep links, and their pockets get deeper and deeper and deeper. Whatever amounts you were mentioning about, ma'am, I know that these are small amounts because I've known that some of those bigger guys, bigger fishes, the amount of money that they can shell out for anything that they want, whatever, like I just know, I said one sentence, let your imagination totally go wild. And all such things unfortunately happen. And the state government, mostly they don't have the will. And the government of India, central government, since the subject is a state subject,
yeah,
they can't interfere.
Yes, no, you're absolutely right. Well, I'm completely out of time. Thank you so much to both you, Mr. Shashikant, and Bhavtosh for joining me on this conversation. Like our guests were saying, not something new. And in fact, you can let your imagination run wild because far worse things happen in these jails. But if it isn't something new, and we know the extent of what goes on, we know the extent of the rot, of the torture, of the corruption that continues in these jails, why is it that we are not able to fix this problem? Why is it that in a simple one prison itself, we are not able to weed out the corruption, despite knowing for decades now that this is the system? Is it overcrowding? Is it way too big? Is it the outsourced staff? Is it the lack of accountability? Whatever be the case, there needs to be some political will in this country, between the state and the central government, to fix this issue. What's the point of putting people behind bars if their criminal activities continue unabated, whether they are inside or outside the jail? Think about that. Thank you so much for joining us on this conversation.